So I got a request to update this video, how to create a parametric cube in SolidWorks, and I took a quick look at the video, and it was made about 6 years ago, so it's definitely time to update it. So let's talk about creating a parametric cube in SolidWorks. Now, creating a cube in SolidWorks is incredibly easy. That's sort of not the point of the video. The point of the video is to both look at how relations and equations allow you to connect dimensions in a model. And this can be useful to create a model that's both easy to scale and easy to create configurations for. It's also useful because you won't have to do work multiple times. You won't have to create dimensions and update them every single time. You can set one dimension and go from there. So I already have the equations folder showing here, but by default that's not shown. So if you go in the options and go into Feature Manager and go to Equations, you can turn on the show. And the point of doing that is we can go directly into this folder and create both variables and equations. Now, if you do create an equation within your part, this folder will automatically show up. But I find it's useful to have it shown so that if we want to create variables, we can do it by using this right-click Manage Equations. So I'm going to add a global variable. And global variables aren't something I use all that frequently, and they're probably not something that you're going to use that frequently. But you can essentially store a character string variable and use it in your dimensions and other places within SolidWorks. So we can do something like cube width. So you just type in cube width, hit enter, and in this case I'm just going to make this a 1-inch cube. And then I'll go ahead and click OK. Now really all I need is to sketch out a square and then extrude that square. So I can draw this wherever I want. I'm going to go ahead and put it on the top plane, use a center rectangle, drop it in on the origin, and then create a dimension. Now this is SolidWorks 2018, and for the last few years the entire sketch will scale when you create your first dimension. So that's something that wasn't part of SolidWorks a few years ago, maybe 4 or 5 years ago. But now when you create a dimension, your sketch will automatically scale. So be careful with adding your dimensions late in the sketching process, because that can really mess up your sketch. So with this we could add another dimension if we wanted. But of course in SolidWorks we have relations. So in this case, it would be best to use a relation if we expected these two lines to stay the same length. So if I control select these two and hit equal, I make those equal. And then if I create an extrusion, I can actually add the equation directly to my dimension box here. And we're going to make it equal to that width that we had before. So if you're using an older version of SolidWorks, I'd say like 2014 or 2013, you might not be able to add the dimension directly in here. Basically you'd need to create an extrusion of 1 inch if you can't do an equals. And then in order to add an equation, you'd have to click on your part or double click if you have Instant 3D off, find your dimension, and then do an equals. But the way you add an equation to either a dimension, to either a smart dimension or to the dimension in this feature, is just to do equals, and then this will bring up a few things. Now we can type something into this box, or we can go to this global variable option and choose this cube width. Now if I update that cube width, that extrusion is going to update. The one thing that's not going to update though is the original dimension from the sketch, because I haven't added an equation yet. Now this will work the same if I add it here outside the sketch, or if I add it inside the sketch. And that, once again, I double clicked on that face, and if you're newer to SolidWorks, Instant 3D is probably turned on. So if you just click on a face, those will show up. The downside with Instant 3D is, one, you might accidentally drag your part to a dimension that you don't want, or accidentally modify the part in a way you don't want. And the other thing here is that if we single click here, oftentimes we're brought into this box, which doesn't give us what we need. So if you turn that off, double click on one of these faces and then double click on this dimension, you can do an equal, and you can make it equal to that cube width. And then now if you go and right click and manage equations, you can modify this width, make it 2, click OK, and you can see that whole square or that whole cube will scale. Now you don't have to create the global variable. You can just simply have a single dimension. And let's say we were to delete that equation. And pretty much the only way to do that, or the easiest way to do that, is go manage equations and then just right click and say delete equation. So I'm going to delete all these out. And then if I once again double click on this face, and let's say I double click on this dimension, I can do an equal and I can choose this dimension. So in order to add that dimension, you either have to see it here on the graphics window, or you have to go into the dimension, see what it's named, and then you can do a double quotes and the name and another double quotation to complete that. Now if I were to edit this dimension, I can once again scale it. Now if you just change the dimension, you do need to hit the rebuild button, and then that will update everything. And with the equation, we can do a lot of things with this. If I want to multiply this by something, let's say times 3. And for this, I think I need to use the asterisk in order to multiply this. But if you do that, now we can have that multiplied by 3. And there's all kinds of things you can do with equations. That's just a very brief introduction to what you're doing and how to sort of work with the parametric aspects of SolidWorks.